guys, and welcome to the fourth episode of Off The Mark. First off, sorry for the delay. We've just been snowed under from work from uni, and we just didn't have time to film last week. So we hope you can forgive us and that we can move on.
All right, now before we begin today's show, we'd like to again thank you for your continued support. Over our three episodes that we've put up so far, we've had over 2,100 views, which we're absolutely thrilled about. But as always, keep on sharing and showing it to your friends so that our view base can become even larger.
Now guys, remember to check out The Substitute, that's the online sports publication Nuwan and I are currently a part of, which is running absolutely brilliantly thanks to our fantastic editor Maddie Johnson.
Yeah.
Now if you don't know, The Substitute is an online sports site contributed to mostly by university students like ourselves. Mm. We cover a range of sports all over the world, so be sure to check it out. Now, Nuwan's just written a preview article of the entire World T20 Cup covering all the teams, and I've written one on the seven players to watch in the coming Australian domestic season. So yeah, have a look and give us some feedback and tell us what you think.
Alright, now today we'll be talking about the Kevin Pietersen controversy and his superb coaching tips, cricket commentary through the eyes of a Sri Lankan, and we begin to get to the bottom of who's a better cricketer between Sanjeet and I.
It's me. It's close.
And we'll also be bringing you some more idiotic sledges that you can throw around at your club level, so enjoy guys.
Enjoy. Now, the main issue we're talking about today is the so-called betrayal by England's number one twit, Kevin Pietersen. Now don't get me wrong, I love KP, he's an exciting batsman, he's a game changer, he can pull off some of the most ridiculous stunts in the middle. But in all honesty, he lacks common sense to just shut his mouth. From his debut in 2005, a lot of people were already questioning and criticising him with his blonde skunk hairstyle and his tattooed bicep featuring the England Lions. But to put it simply, he's amazingly talented. I mean, anyone who can do this...
Whoa, what a shot.
Or even this.
Oh, did you see that?
Or even this. Like, what is this?
I'm Kevin Pietersen, and this is Blindfold Cricket.
Coming down now. There we go.
That's it. That's
You've
it.
Got to be joking.
Oh! Wow. What a go. Oh my god.
Clearly has a skill to play international cricket. I saw that. That was crazy.
Well, look, if you're not aware of what's going on, Kevin Pietersen's career as an England batsman is currently hanging by a thread. He's been having a few serious problems that go all the way to May of this year.
On the 29th of May this year, he announced his retirement from one day in T20 cricket for England, and then offered to reverse his decision only if the ECB allowed him to play the whole IPL.
Then, on the 4th of August, Kevin Pietersen belted the South African senseless with a beautiful 149 in the second test. But later that night, he states, "It's tough being me in the dressing room," hinting at a fractured relationship with the other players and considers retiring from test cricket.
It's a hard life for KP. A week later, Andrew Strauss and KP meet after the newspapers report that KP's been sending text messages bagging out Strauss to the South African players. Matt Prior acts as a mediator to create peace.
Then on the next day, Kevin Pietersen posts a video on YouTube doing a backflip on his decision to retire and declares himself available for all three formats of the game because he loves playing cricket for England.
The day after that, KP is dropped from the England team for the third test because he was not forthcoming about those stupid text messages he sent.
Then by day four of the test match, in which Kevin Pietersen was dropped, he issues a public apology for the provocative text messages that he sent to the South African men. Andrew Strauss doesn't accept this and says that the issue needs to be dealt with face to face.
On the 18th of August, the newspaper reveals some of the contents of Pietersen's text, which we won't repeat. Mm. Things get icier between KP and Strauss.
So, while he goes back to playing county cricket the next day, Pietersen is bowled for a golden duck against Hampshire and gets booed onto and off the ground. Andy Flower, the England coach, states that there are deeper issues that need to be fixed and that these must be resolved before KP can ever play for England again.
A week later, Andrew Strauss retires from international cricket and states that the Kevin Pietersen rift had absolutely nothing to do with it, but we're not so sure.
And look, just before filming this segment, we also logged on to Crick Info, like true cricket fanatics, and we found that Kevin Pietersen hasn't been offered an ECB Central contract at all.
Now this could be the end of the saga, we're not sure, but as you know, a lot has gone on. But the main issue that people are having is the fact that KP sent tactics to Morkland Steyn, telling them to go around the wicket to knock Strauss over. Now I'm no tactical genius, but it seems to me that this might have been done before.
Ooh, and what a great catch is it?
I can't remember who did it. Someone has been using this tactic with success before.
What a superb delivery there.
Oh, it just seems so familiar. I just can't pick who has done this before.
Done.
Beautifully bowled by Morne.
Oh yeah, that's right. Morkel himself has been using this tactic for the past 4 years, long before KP told him about it. By this logic, maybe Kevin Pietersen and his eternal coaching wisdom might let us in on some insights, tactical insights, about 4 years too late.
Oh dude, wait, I just got a text message right now.
What's that?
It's from KP.
Oh really?
It says, go around the wicket to Gilchrist, he can't face it.
Cheers, KP. We didn't know that one.
Hold on. It says, bowl Yorkers to tailenders.
That gram is on fire.
On the ball as always, KP.
Wait,
you got another one.
There's one more where he's got, Indians can't play the short ball.
Kevin Pietersen. Wow, you are a tactical god. I bet nobody on the face of the earth knew that one.
But look, back to what we're essentially saying. Kevin Pietersen suggested that during the second test that South Africa's bowlers go around the wicket to Strauss. Dale Steyn used this tactic to dismiss Strauss in the first innings. Morne Morkel also dismissed Strauss for bowling from around the wicket in the first test at the Oval.
Now let's be honest guys, there's only two ways for a bowler to bowl, over the wicket or round. Even if Pietersen told him to do it, it's a pretty fair bet that the South Africans have already analysed Strauss's play enough and would have already had their own techniques to get him out, namely going around the wicket. The inference made that Pietersen would damage his own team is a bit far-fetched. He might be a massive tosser, but his sportsmanship should not be so lightly questioned. The New England captain himself, Alistair Cook, recently said that England can't be number one again without Kevin Pietersen. I say bring him back. He might say stupid things and be a tactical moron, but he has talent. I reckon he should still play.
No, he shouldn't play, man. He's a shit, but look at this technique.
Man, you're a shit bro. Look at you.
You're half of your shit.
Get out. You're fired
from the cricket. Well, hey guys, we've been having a bit of a dispute for a couple of years now about
time.
Who's the better cricketer between me and Sanjeet.
It's me.
Psh, you wish, man. So, we decided over the course of about three weeks, we're going to have a bit of a cricketing challenge to see who's the best. So today we're going to
have a bowl off, essentially 10 balls at the stumps. Whoever hits the stumps more wins. It's pretty simple. So, yeah, I know you guys watching are wanting me to win, so we'll see what happens now.
All right, we'll see you, man. Have fun. Whoa.
Alright, we've got Nuwan coming into bowl now. Here we go. His first ball. And that is absolute tripe. That has bounced four times. Second delivery. Running into bowl, he switched to pace here. And that looks online. But oh, it's just coming off. Think I see it. Nuwan's third delivery coming in.
You looked a lot older. You've been working out. What's wrong with that?
Oh, it's bounced over the stump. To the gods. Here we go, delivery number 10. And he's missed. That's 10 from 10 that Nuwan has missed. Zero.
You got a bowl now, right?
All right. Hey, what is
special occasion to do it for the money. Can't go wrong with that.
One from
7 was 0 for run.
Piss off.
It's over 1 second. Yeah!
Who are you?
So that was the first challenge finish. He didn't last very long. He bowled 10 balls, didn't make contact even once. I bowled 2 balls. Hit once, as you can see. The stump has fallen from my brilliant bowling. And Nuwan is supposed to be the bowler out of the bunch of us.
Yeah, I was getting too much, you know, bounce, too much turn, you know. It's...
Well, then why don't you switch to pace?
Because I don't bowl pace.
Because you can't bowl.
Well, hey.
Well, that's part one. That's one to me.
The first thing in becoming a Sri Lankan cricket commentator is to state the obvious.
You know, I think they need to score some runs, otherwise they cannot win the match. I think they're going to play some cricket today. You know, I think when he's bowling, he's trying to get a wicket.
No shit, Sherlock.
The next step is to say absolutely useless things irrelevant to the cricket.
Oh, Sanjeet's wife is looking very lovely today. Ah, oh, I can see Malinga's younger brother in the crowd over there. Oh, sorry, that's his girlfriend. And as you can see, it's a lovely sunny day today. Not a single cloud in the sky. And except for that one cloud over there. Oh, sorry, that's a plane.
The next step is to not follow the cricket or the state of the match whatsoever.
Oh no, he's dropped the catch! Sri Lanka have lost this one! Oh no, wait, he got the catch! Sri Lanka won this match, then won the match! Oh, good one! Oh, that's a beautiful shot there by Jayasurya. Yeah, why is he walking back to the dressing room? You know, he's a very talented bowler, you know, Ricky Ponting? Ricky Ponting?
The next step is to be always eternally pessimistic about Sri Lanka's chances. Always favour the other team. Always.
I don't think Sri Lanka can do it, you know. They need 5 more runs to win and about 6 more wickets in hand, but I don't think they can win this one. No, they can't win it. Well, Jayasurya is out now and Sri Lanka are definitely going to lose this match. You know, I think Michael Clarke is batting too well. You know, the Sri Lankan bowlers, they cannot get him out. He's too good, too good.
The final step in becoming a Sri Lankan cricket commentator is to say awkward things.
Oh, Mahela is a good partner for Sangakkara when they are batting together. And you can see McGrath is getting very frustrated there, you know. He's not getting any action from the fielders. Oh, that is a most beautiful, delicious, delightful shot there by Sangakkara. He's one of the most beautiful, elegant players in the game today.
You have been watching How to Be a Sri Lankan Cricket Commentator. This motion picture was brought to you by Dilmati. Do try it.
Home, you're wasting my time here.
Mate, this is the ball. This is what it looks like. You have no idea what's going on.
Thank you for watching today.
You guys know the drill. We'll tell you every week. Yep. Share it, subscribe it, show your friends.
Yeah, anyone?
Yeah, we really appreciate the support.
And tune in for the next episode, guys.
We hope you guys had fun. What else is there to say? There's nothing.
No.
Yeah, we've taken up enough of your time.
Alright, see ya.
Goodbye.
Bye.
I'm sorry, what was that?
Well, it's too heavy.
Oh.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, is that from being rich or just not ever spending money?
A bit of both.
A bit of both, alright.
Stupid text messages he sent.
By day four of the test, in which Kevin Pietersen says, I don't know how to do it again.
Is it going?
No.
Okay. Oh shit, man.
Oh no.
We're gonna have to clean it when we go.
I told you to miss it.
Sorry.
He's kidding.